welcome back to my channel. My name is Shelby and today I'm going to be doing my November book haul. I have over 30 books to talk about. I did quite a bit of swapping and I actually only bought 3 new books. So I was really lucky. I won some giveaways. I got a book from an author. Like I said, I did some swapping. I also did a little bit of used bookstore shopping. So since I have so many to talk about, I will link all these down below and let's get right into it. So the book that I was sent by an author, I am really excited about. The author is actually subscribed to me and she reached out to me asking if I would review her book. And after reading the synopsis, I knew it sounded like something I was interested in. And that is The Artist Retreat by Brooke Bailey. And I absolutely love this cover. So I'm just going to read you what's on the back of the book because I think she describes it best. It says, Sedone Covington is an artist of critical acclaim. Unfortunately, she also happens to be the daughter of a convicted murderer. Sedone turns to art therapy after discovering her father's victims, creating their likeness through sculpture as a means of healing for herself and honoring their lives. Sedone gifts the sculptures to a struggling gallery owner badly in need of captivating work that can make her relevant again. The owner's daughter, Chloe Jacobs, is an art school student tasked with shadowing a local artist. Not long after Sedone and Chloe's worlds collide, Chloe disappears. When the missing person case loses steam, local media outlets begin receiving mixed media installations bearing Chloe's signature. Each piece is a carefully crafted social commentary on the way her disappearance is being handled. In Chloe's absence, her community has to come to terms with whether or not she's behind the work and if they'll ever see her again. And that sounds really good, and so I'm really excited to read it, hoping I can get to it before 2020. So thank you so much to the author for sending this to me. And then I never try to enter giveaways on Instagram, so I entered a whole bunch this month and I actually won 2 of them, so I'm super excited. The first one that I won is Chasing Beverly by Ashlyn Cubison. I've never heard of this book or this author, but this is just an independently published romance and it looked really cute, and when I read the synopsis at the time, it sounded good. The next one I'm also really excited for, and that is Not the Girl You Marry by Andy J. Christopher. And this one I've heard mixed reviews for, but it's gotten a lot of buzz. So I'm curious to see if I'm going to like it or not. And then the next one I have was just randomly gifted to me by my mother. I sent her a wish list for Christmas. She wanted to get me some books, but she said that this one didn't fit in her package that she was sending me for Christmas. And so instead she just gave it to me the last time I saw her. And that is The Perfect Son by Lauren North. And if you guys know, I really enjoyed this book. I read it months ago as an ARC and I loved it. And I recommended it to several other people. And I really wanted to own my own copy just because I liked it so much. So I'm really thankful that my mother bought it for me. And thank you so much, Mom. And then for the 3 books that I bought, the first one I bought was a really good deal on Amazon. It was only like $6 and some change. It is a book in a series that is recommended by Nicole over at The Girly Girl Bookworm. She really likes this series. I don't know what the series is called, but the first book is The Start of Something Good. It's a small town romance series centering around a bed and breakfast and a family who owns it. So that sounds really cute, and I thought this cover was adorable. The next is one I got off of Book Depository, and that is The Family by Louise Jensen. You guys know I really like her books, and this one centers around a cult. And I also really like cult thrillers, so I'm hoping I love this one. The next is a pre-order, and that is The Last Affair by Margot Hunt. If you guys have been watching my channel, you guys know I love For Better and Worse by Margot Hunt, which was her release of 2018, so I knew I had to pick this one up and I can't wait to get to it. And then a couple weeks ago, my husband and I went to Half Price Books, which is about an hour away, and I sold back a ton of books, and we went out to lunch, and we just had a really nice day, and I ended up picking up a few books. The first one I got is The Invited by Jennifer McMahon, and I read an ARC of this back in the spring, and I loved it, so I knew I wanted to own my own copy. This is a really spooky ghost story, so if you like kind of paranormal reads, I think you would like this one. The next 2 are books 2 and 3 in the Peach Bluff series. I don't know the order, but they're both by Kristen Woodson Harvey, and the first one I have is The Southern Side of Paradise. And the second one is The Secret of Southern Charm. And I received the first book in the series from Nicole as a birthday present. And that one's called Slightly South of Simple. And I've heard the series is just so good, so I wanted to stock up when I saw them for a good price. And I can't wait to read them next summer. The next 4 are all independently published romances. I was really on the lookout for some of those, but my Half Price Books doesn't have a great selection. But they did have a few, and I'm really excited about the ones I got. The first one is Ink and Lies by S.L. Jennings. And I've heard a couple people talk about this. I've heard Lisa Books and Smiles, she mentioned this a long time ago, and then I also heard Jess over at Peace Love Books recently talk about it, so when I saw it I knew I had to pick it up. Then the next one is Waterfall Effect by KK Allen. I've heard great things about this author, but I haven't heard anyone talk about this book in particular. It is a chunky book, but the text is really large, so I'm hoping it doesn't take me forever to get through. But I've heard great things about this author, and I'm hoping I love this one. The next one is The Start of a Series, and it's by an author duo I really enjoy, and that is Tapping the Billionaire by Max Munro, and this is The Billionaire Bad Boys Book 1, and I think it's just about a bunch of guys who are all billionaires and their romance stories, which sounds really good, and I do like Max Munro as an author duo, so I'm really happy I picked this one up too. The last one, I've never heard anything about it, I've never heard anyone talk about it, and that is The Opposite of You by Rachel Higginson, and I just thought the cover was really pretty, the spine was nice. I think it's an opposites attract type of story, and it had good ratings on Goodreads, so I'm definitely going to give it a try. The rest of the books are books that I swapped for. In November, Kendra and I did a swap box for the holidays. She sent me one new book that was off of my Amazon wishlist, so thank you so much, Kendra. She sent me Park Avenue Player by V. Keelan and Penelope Ward, and I read this back in September or October, and I loved it, so I'm so happy to have a copy for my shelves. Then she also sent me her copy of The Cabin at the End of the World by Paul Tremblay. She didn't really like this one, but I do plan on reading it eventually. It is rather short. And then my friend Nicole over at the Girly Girl Bookworm, she sent me a copy of a book she was planning on unhauling, and that is A Mother's Confession by Kelly Rimmer. I don't know the premise of this one, but I really like Kelly Rimmer's writing, so I hope I love this one. The next two are from a girl I swapped with on a Facebook group, and I will link that group down below. And she sent me A Nearly Normal Family by M.T. Edvardsen, and this one I believe is a rather new thriller. This was an ARC copy, but I've heard some good things about it. I don't know the premise, but I'm happy to have it. And the next one is The First Mistake by Sandy Jones. I read this one months ago from the library and I really liked it, so I'm really happy to have a copy for my shelves. Then my last stack of books is from Beth over at Beth and the Books. Her and I did a swap box. We were collecting books for months and we finally did our trade in November. She sent me a few mass market type of paperbacks. The first one is Blackout by Lisa Unger. This is a thriller. And then she sent me Under My Skin by Lisa Unger as well, because she knew I wanted to read more by this author. And then she also knew I wanted to read more by J.T. Allison, so she sent me Lie to Me. And then the next one I've never heard anything about, and that is When All the Girls Have Gone by Jane Ann Krentz. I have to take the library cover off of it, but it is a kind of mystery, I believe. The next one is Under a Silent Moon by Elizabeth Haynes, and it's really funny. I almost bought this from Half Price Books, but I didn't. And I just read another book by her in November that was recommended to me by Beth, so I'm excited to get to this one. And then I told her I'd been kind of wanting to read a book by Jamie Brenner, so she got me The Husband Hour, and I think this is just a women's fiction set in the summertime. And then she got me Eleanor Oliphant is Completely Fine by Gail Honeyman. I've heard a lot of people recommend this one, so I'm excited to have it too. And then I asked her to send me this one my way because she read it and I've been interested in it, and that is The Siren by Tiffany Rise. And this is from the Original Sinners series, and I'm really excited to read it because I've heard so many good recommendations about this series. The next one is Little Mercies by Heather Gudenkauf. I've read one other book by this author, but I've heard a lot of things about this book, and I've heard good things as well as some bad things, so I'm excited to see if I love it. The next is one that was recommended by Kendra, and that is Hunting Annabelle by Wendy Hurd. I heard this one is pretty messed up, so if Kendra recommends it, I'm sure I'll love it. And then I'm so excited for this one. It's a rather newer book, and that is Evie Drake Starts Over by Linda Holmes. I've heard such good things about it, and it's a really cute cover. It is some type of women's fiction slash romance. The next one, I don't know what it's about, but it is an art copy of The Last Romantics by Tara Conklin. No idea what it's about, but I guess I'll find out when I read it. Almost done, just two left. I'm really excited. I have our December Thriller Talks After Dark pick in here, and that is Her Pretty Face by Robin Harding. And this one is a domestic thriller. And then the very last one for the month is If You Were Here by Alifair Burke. I've read two other books by this author and I liked them. I never heard of this one, but yeah, I'm excited to pick it up. So those are all the books that I acquired in the month of November. I would love to hear if you've read any of these. That way I know if you liked them. I'll link them all down below, and I will see you guys on my next one. Bye.